Hello, welcome to chemistry course. Last class we have discussed about synthesis of vitamin A. In this class, I'm going to explain synthesis of vitamin C from D-glucose. Let's look at the structure of vitamin C. And it is also commonly called as L-ascorbic acid. It is a cyclic 5-member ring system which is having one chiral center here. Let's move on to synthesis of vitamin C. How we can synthesize vitamin C from D-glucose? Let's start with the D-glucose. In first step, aldehyde group in the glucose is converted into alcohol by hydrogenation reaction. CHO group, which is present in the D-glucose, converted into CH2OH alcohol in the first step by catalytic reduction, that is under hydrogenation high pressure reaction, it is converted into sorbitol. In next step, that is step 2, sorbitol and oxidation gives sorbose, and this oxidation can be done by using microorganism, and we know that microorganism are known for specific reactions. By taking a acetobacter suboxidane, one microorganism which oxidizes very specifically fifth carbon hydroxyl group into corresponding keto. It is a secondary alcohol converted into keto group. So this reaction carry out in the microorganism. In this conversion and in this step, selectively we are oxidizing fifth carbon hydroxy into keto group. As a result of this oxidation, we got a product called L-sorbose. Before going into next step, we have to rearrange sorbose structure. And here I am taking a sorbose, L-sorbose. According to rules of Fischer projection formula, more oxidizable group should be present on top. So what I am doing to convert proper orientation, I am rotating this molecule into 180 degrees such that this bottom carbon will go to top, and here top carbon will here come to bottom, and this is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 member ketoses, and we know that 6 member ketoses, ketohexoses, are in the aqueous medium always it will exist in the two forms, open chain and cyclic form, and I am writing their corresponding cyclic structure. So the cyclic hemiacetal formation will be there in this fashion. As a result, we get a furanose form. And here, OH is oriented in the up, CH2OH is here, and next is hydroxyl left side, which is above, and hydroxyl, which is right side below. And this oxygen is involved in the acetal formation, and CH2OH we have written in this fashion. Now, by taking this molecule, I'm moving into next. In third step, we have to oxidize one of the primary alcohol into carboxylic acid. But we have a two primary alcohol and secondary alcohol. So whatever the reagent we are using for this process, it cannot convert one alcohol into carboxylic acid. So before going into this step, in this step, we have to protect the remaining alcohol functionality by taking proper protecting group. So in this process, we have a very good method is there, that is acetone protection. 2 moles of acetone, which will react with adjacent alcohol, and it is converted into diacetonide. One of the alcohol will be there in the free. So 1 mole, it can react here, and another mole of acetone can react with these two alcohol, which can form diacetonide. So this is the first carbon, second, third, fourth, fifth and sixth carbon. So basically second carbon, third carbon hydroxy is protected, that is 2 and 3. 4 and 6 carbon hydroxy, it is protected, 4, 6 diisopropylidene sorbose. This is a sorbose in cyclic hemiacetal structure we are protecting. Now only one primary alcohol which is left. Now we can go for the oxidation of this primary alcohol by taking oxidizing agent. In next step, we are converting primary alcohol into carboxylic acid by taking suitable oxidizing agent KMnO4 in alkaline medium, which converts the primary alcohol into carboxylic acid. Now the purpose of protection is it should not involve in the reaction. Now selectively we have converted this primary alcohol into acid. Now we have to go for removing of this protection, that is called deprotection step. This deprotection can be carried out in acidic medium, which cleavage will take place here, which is converted into again free hydroxyl group. And this I am writing in the open chain structure. So it is oriented in this fashion. COH will come top and here C double bond O, and OH is top, should be there left in the Fischer projection formula. And next carbon OH is right, it should be there in the right side in the Fischer projection formula, and remaining I have written. And this compound is called 2-keto, at second position keto glucuronic acid, and it is a L-glucuronic acid. The hydroxyl group at highest chiral center oriented in the left side, we call it as L-glucuronic acid. In final step, acid catalyzed reaction on 2-keto glucuronic acid is converted into required ascorbic acid, L-ascorbic acid or vitamin C. Under acid catalyzed reaction, first it will undergo tautomerization, and this hydrogen is next to the keto group, which converted into enolation. So I am writing here, and this carbon is now OH double bond OH OH and CH2OH, and this is called acid catalyzed tautomerization. After that it will undergo cyclization reaction, by elimination of water molecule, which results vitamin C, and this is called gamma lactonization. Here this is alpha carbon, beta carbon and gamma. So the water molecule is eliminated from the gamma hydroxy, which gives cyclic ester. This is called as lactonization. As a result of this cyclic lactonization gives desired product L-ascorbic acid or vitamin C. And this is about the synthesis of vitamin C from D-glucose.